In my editing, I deal with two types of pops. I deal with those P-pop plosives because I don't have a pop filter nearby, because I have up until recently used this little thing to go directly into my phone, and this doesn't have a limiter or a low-cut filter. And most importantly, I don't know how to control my goddamn voice. And the other type of pop I encounter often is that jump cut pop, and I'll look for some examples and I'll insert it right here. Settings. To render previews, you can enable the... Now, P-pops or plosives occur because the air that comes out of your mouth while making that sound. Plosive. That air hits the microphone and creates a low frequency distortion or a rumble. And on top of that, our audio tends to peak from the sound recording too loud. Our input is too loud and peaks, and so the output will peak, pop, and distort. Rumble. You can control for this by using a foam cover and a pop filter. The pop filter kind of helps by slowing down or dampening that fast traveling of air before it hits your microphone. Another way to potentially manage those pops would be if you have a recording device that has a volume limiter. The recommendation would be to set the recording limit or the input limit to minus 12 decibels, and in that way your peaks are less likely to exceed 0 decibels, and this would be much easier to volume control in post. You won't record a distorted audio peak, and therefore you won't have distorted audio or peaks to edit in post. Some devices have the added options to set low cuts or high pass filters, which are helpful in windy scenarios and can specifically help with plosives that result from P's, from K's, and from distortions that you get from the clapping. Now, if I mess up and hit a plosive, which happens relatively often for me because I'm not always great at controlling my voice, and this mic over here, it doesn't have any filters, and I just got this new thing here, which has a limiter, some low cut filters, so let's see how that goes. Now, I'll tackle the plosives in two ways. For method number one, I isolate the plosive, navigate to effects, audio effects, filter and EQ, and I select the FFT filter. I drag that over the isolated audio clip and I select kill the mic rumble. This works about 50% of the time for me, so sometimes if I shift this over a little, I get a better result, and sometimes I get lucky when meddling with the curve a little more frantically. Plosive. And if that doesn't work, I isolate the peak with the pen tool and I try reduce the peak so it's less invasive to the ears, but this never sounds great. If I'm making a short piece or a commercial piece, I re-record, and if it's just a YouTube video like a tutorial, I heavily rely on my music to distract. And the other pop is a jump cut pop, and this happens when your audio wave from the previous clip is significantly different to the audio wave from the second clip. And I'll use an example, I'll put an example wherever the arrows are pointing. So as a light rule, I try cut where there is no audio wave, and if I can't avoid that, I place an audio transition. And it's this one here, the crossfade, exponential fade. I drag that transition at the cut and I narrow it down to as small as I can. And what this does is it smoothly fades the volume down and then smoothly back up. And if you want, you can manually do this with the pen tool again, but the transition works best for me. To render previews, you can enable the work. Final bits of advice that I sadly don't always follow is try keep your voice somewhat controlled at the mic. Keep a healthy distance to the mic, maybe a foot or 30 centimeters. Don't record directly to your camera, you're better off just using your phone. I made a video on that, so it's somewhere in the description or up above if that's something you might be interested in. Be wary of your P's, your S's, your K's, your claps, your bumps. Use foam and a pop filter if you can. And if you have the option to limit your volume of recording, do consider doing so. If you have the option to apply a high pass filter or a low cut filter, do consider doing so. I recently got myself this dedicated recorder, which I'm using for the first time today. I'm very excited, and once I have a good amount of experience with this, I'll dedicate a video to this. So let's wait and see how that goes. And let's just end things there. But before we say our goodbyes, as you know, I rely heavily on music, not only to drive mood in my videos, but as I just mentioned a minute ago, I use music to distract from my plosive mess-ups. Generally speaking, music plays an integral role in my videos. And if you're into the music I've been using in my videos of late, feel free to check out and explore audio.com's music licensing catalog. They're running a holiday deal where you can pay one price, that's $199, to get lifetime access to their royalty-free music licensing. Thousands of high-quality tracks at hands down the best value. I've made various videos covering my thoughts and opinions, so feel free to check those out if that's something you might be interested in. If you're a new-time filmmaker, YouTuber, vlogger, commercial content creator, whatever you lot are doing these days, if you're looking for subjectively great music to incorporate in your videos, I do recommend you give them a listen. Details link below. And that's it for today, folks. If you found this video helpful, useful, entertaining, if you feel you may have learned something, do consider giving it a thumbs up if that's something you do. Share, subscribe if that's something you might be interested in doing. All that good stuff. As always, thank you so much for watching. I sincerely appreciate you for being here, and I'll catch you in the next video.